Good morning. Happy Sabbath. Try that again. Good morning. Happy Sabbath. Amen. Amen. I want to, on behalf of our senior pastor, Wes Peppers, and his wife, Marion, who are at the marriage retreat this weekend, and our board of elders, we want to welcome all of you to the Lansing Seventh-day Adventist Church. And for those watching via our social media sites and the live stream, welcome as well. Church family, visitors, family, and friends. I have a few announcements for you before we, and we want to welcome Great Lakes Adventist Academy Music Department today. Amen. Amen. Excited to have all of you young people here. Praise the Lord. Amen. And their family who has come as well. One of the highlights for us this year here at the church is to have these young people come down and minister unto us, young and old. Minister to us in music this day. Amen. A little cold this morning, wasn't it? A little chilly. Amen. But praise the Lord for the sunshine. And also, I want to acknowledge on this Veterans Day weekend all of our veterans who have served or are currently serving in the military. Thank you for all of your service and duty. And we appreciate that. And make sure you know that we thank you for all that you've done for this country. So our other announcement, I want to acknowledge Sister Ella Cousins. She is the wife of Brother Howard Cousins, who's actually standing in the foyer back there. Her sister passed away this week, and Sister Ella is flying out, I believe, tomorrow to Georgia. And she's going to meet her other family there, and then they're going to head on to Alabama, where the funeral actually will take place next Sabbath, November 19th, down in Alabama. So please remember Sister Ella and Howard Cousins in your prayer during this time. I think, if I remember correctly, her sister was just a couple of years older than she was when she passed away. I'm not sure what she passed away from, but you can see Brother Howard or Pastor or myself if you want their phone number or contact information. One other thing, Sister Rosalina Dabner, I think you have heard Pastor talk about her during his sermons. She is the lady who's actually, she's like a cat, she's got like nine lives, and Pastor showed a picture of her before. She is currently at Sparrow Hospital, kind of unresponsive at this time. And so I would ask that you remember Rosalina Dabner in your prayers, and if you want to visit her, please let me or Pastor Aaron Cruz know, and then we'll let you know where she's at in Sparrow Hospital. Our other announcement is, now you've seen this one here actually in your flyer, in your bulletin. It's the Gratitude Project, and right on it is some instructions that list exactly what we're looking for from the church congregation, and really it's to place in, there's a basket right in the back there in the foyer, and we're asking for you to share with us the ways that God has been, that you've been thankful for God this year. And what you would do is actually fill out the leaf right here on the back, and then you would cut the, turn that in, and then what the students are doing from glass is actually placing that on that tree that's right in the back there. And then next Sabbath, there is a Vespers, November 19th, where we'll be talking more about the things that have been, you've been thankful for this year. So not so much really a glass project in as much as we're asking glass, the young people are cutting this out. So make sure you pay attention to this, and the Vespers next week, that's going to take place November 19th. There is a Sabbath School Council meeting this afternoon following our church worship service. So if you have any questions, see our Sabbath School Superintendent, Bonnie Ubman. And then there's also a fellowship, all church and GLA fellowship lunch. So not only are we going to, we're excited that you guys are here, we're actually going to be feeding you as well. Because we know young people, you all like to eat. Amen. So that's down in the gymnasium there, and we are excited about that. Tomorrow morning, there's a prayer breakfast at 10 o'clock a.m. down in the fellowship hall. You can see Sister Nola Collins regarding that. And then also tomorrow, November 13th, you can pick up your fruit order in the gym from 1 to 4. Is that right? 1 to 4 McDonald's? Okay. 1 to 4 p.m. tomorrow down in the gym. So see those guys for that. And then one last other announcement that I need to make sure that we're crystal clear on is our Pathfinders are next Sabbath, November 19th in the afternoon, are going to be handing out Thanksgiving Day baskets for those who are in need. And on the back page of the bulletin, give some instructions. So there's two different things that are going on, church. One, you have the can collecting that the Pathfinders go out and do in partnership with our community service center, who they work through the food bank, collecting that for the people in the community. And then we have Pathfinders who collect food for that they've been authorized by the church board to, I believe there's like 40 or 50 Thanksgiving baskets that we're gonna be handing out. So on this bulletin here, on the announcements, there is instructions that the Pathfinders are looking for, which talks about stuffing, cornbread, gravy, canned fruit, cranberry sauce, and corn muffin mix, and those different things that are gonna be needed. Because what's gonna happen is if we don't chip in, then we actually as a church will, church board will be paying for that as well. So anything you can do to help that and not be confused with what Marvin and his team does over at the Community Service Center is would be greatly appreciated. Other than that, the rest of the announcements are in your bulletin and you can take a look at those. Our call to worship this morning is taken from the 117th division of the Book of Psalms. So if you have your Bibles, go there. Psalms 117, verse 1 and 2, before our praise team comes up, our glad praise team comes up and prepares us to worship with the Lord. Psalms 117, two verses. When you have it, let me hear you say amen. Psalms 117 says, "Praise the Lord, all you Gentiles. Laud him, all you peoples, for his merciful kindness is great toward us. And the truth of the Lord endures forever. Praise the Lord." May the Lord add a rich blessing to the reading of his word, and God bless you on this wonderful Sabbath. Praise team.
Gracious Lord, as we begin this service today, we want to praise you and thank you for your Holy Spirit. We want to ask that that Spirit would move through our hearts, that it would move through the hearts of these young people. Thank you for Adventist education. Thank you for our schools that are evangelism centers, seeking to bring young people closer and closer to Jesus. So Lord, we ask that in Jesus' name, you would put up a hedge around this sanctuary, around each of our hearts, that we may receive the blessing that you have prepared. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you.
O God of heaven, Lord, we petition your throne this morning in the name of your Son, Jesus the Christ, our Lord and Savior, the author and finisher of our faith, thanking you that we can once again come into your house of worship, Heavenly Father, to be through the power of your Holy Spirit. Lord, we thank you for the Sabbath and for a day that you've set aside from all others, Heavenly Father, that we can indeed worship with you in spirit and in truth. Lord, we thank you for bringing us through this week, a challenging week for us individually, for our country as a whole, but we know that you're in complete command of all that is going on. And so we take comfort in knowing you as our Lord and Savior, for knowing your word, and for what shall transpire here in the last days. And Lord, it's a time for us to do a self-examination of our lives and recommit and commit our lives unto you through the power of the Holy Spirit, Heavenly Father, that as things unfold here in the United States, Lord, we can know that through your scripture, what shall play out here, and it wouldn't come as a surprise to us. So we praise your holy name for not allowing us to be in darkness, but to indeed be in light, and that we, as your people, can tell someone about Jesus and what he has done for us. And Lord, we pray and thank you for Great Lakes Adventist Academy Music Department coming to our church here today. You would allow them to be able to draw closer unto Christ as a result of their time. They minister unto us. We pray for the silent prayer request that is on the hearts of the saints here today, that they would lay it down at the foot of the cross, and that you would answer it, those prayers according to thy will. Lord, we ask for the forgiveness of our sins and shortcomings, and Lord, we just ask that we continue to seek ye first your kingdom and all of your righteousness, Lord, and that we would indeed have that Christ-like spirit, that you would cleanse us from all unrighteousness, and that we could have that peace, Jesus, that passes all understanding. So bless these young people today. Lord, may the angels again join in with us here today, and that, Lord, when we leave this place, that we would be better than when we first came in. Be with us now, and thank you for hearing this prayer and for the silent prayer request. In Jesus' name and for his sake, let the church say, amen.
Thank you. Thank you.
And the church said?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Just want two things before we have the benediction here. Invite you down into our gymnasium, which is out the door and to the left, and then down the steps, and then you kind of make a veer to the right and kind of a left, and then just a straight beeline to the gym for our fellowship lunch. What'd I say? Sorry about that. And then the other thing is for the church family, 5 o'clock p.m., Veterans Day tribute with Elder Leroy Brook as he gives his testimony to for his time in the military there. So, and then the Bible says in Jude 1:24-25, now to him who is able to keep you from stumbling and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to our God, our Savior, who alone is wise, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forever. Amen. Let us pray. Father in heaven, Lord, we thank you in the name of Jesus for our time here. We thank you for Great Lakes Adventist Academy, their music department, Lord, how we have indeed been blessed to be ministered unto this day via music. Thank you for these young people, Lord, and we just praise your holy name that the angels joined in, and Lord, that again, we have been blessed this day. We ask a special blessing upon the food that has been prepared for us, Lord, and bless the hands that have prepared it. And when it's, Lord, we give you glory and honor and praise for what thou has done for us this day. In Jesus' name and for his sake, let the church say, amen. Amen. God bless you.